The biggest problem of any new website owner is the question, what kind of web hosting should I get? There's shared hosting, managed WordPress hosting, cloud hosting, VPS hosting. What's the difference? Well, long story short, shared hosting is cheap, easy to use, yet slow and lacks power. VPS or cloud hosting is expensive, hard to use, but powerful. This used to leave people in a tough situation. Do I go for a weak and easy to use solution, or do I spend the time learning and managing more powerful servers? But what if I told you that you don't have to choose anymore? Because there are providers that are starting to bridge the gap between cheap, powerful, yet still easy to use, so anyone could get started fast. Welcome to Emit.Reviews, where I provide you with real and honest information about web hosting. In today's topic, we have ScalaHosting, a primarily cloud or VPS hosting provider. And actually, cloud or VPS hosting is getting much cheaper. It's also faster and safer for your website. So the question is, why aren't more people using cloud or VPS hosting over the traditional shared web hosting solutions? Because it used to be complicated. Managing remote servers, installing and configuring software without even having a user interface. There was a lot of room for error. But companies like ScalaHosting are now offering the simplicity of shared web hosting together with the performance and benefits of cloud or VPS hosting. And for today's video, I've actually bought one of their plans maybe half a year ago so I could set up some tests. And today we'll finally go over everything and I'll tell you my opinion about ScalaHosting. The biggest advantage of using ScalaHosting over other VPS or cloud hosting companies is the fact that you get a control panel together with your server, and the control panel is totally free. This is how it looks. As you can see here, it shows how many resources your server is currently using, so you're never in a situation where you unknowingly go over the limits, like with shared web hosting, and basically crash your website. But the most interesting part is here, in the S panel. S panel is the custom developed tool by ScalaHosting. It only comes with ScalaHosting plans. If you would click login to S panel, you would be taken to your server management tools. Now, here you can create as many websites as you want, just by clicking on create account and filling out the new website information. So with ScalaHosting, you're actually not buying web hosting packages or plans or stuff like that. You're just buying server resources. And the way you choose to use your resources is completely up to you. You could host one really large website, or just 100 small ones. Especially if you're a freelance developer, you could use your server to host your clients' projects and bill them for the hosting. And once you click list accounts, you can see all of the different websites that you're currently hosting on your server. For example, here I have protechwear.com, and it's currently taking up 124 megabytes of space on my server. Now, ScalaHosting allows you to manage all of the accounts separately by clicking login next to each one. And this takes you to the S panel, like just deeper inside of it, which in terms of functionality is exactly what you would see on a shared web hosting plan with C panel. Except remember, this isn't shared hosting. This is your own private server that comes with a few perks that you might not think about. One huge advantage of having your own private server instead of having to rely on shared web hosting solutions is the fact that you get a dedicated IP address. You do not have to share your IP address with other users, because sharing an IP address is actually a legitimate problem most of the time. Imagine there are 100 people that share the same IP because they're using shared hosting. And only 5 of them start sending out spam emails. Because the IP address that the mails are being sent from is the same for all 100 users, the 95 regular users will then have their emails marked as spam as well, even though they're not sending any spam, they're just sharing the spammy IP address. If you're using a privately owned server, this problem would never happen. Well, unless you are the one that's sending all those spam emails, and in that case, well, you kinda deserve it. Anyways, let's dive into the S panel and see what they're offering under the hood.
So you have the option to create a website from an installer script.
Obviously, you have the most popular choices like WordPress, but inside Softaculous there are other scripts available for e-commerce, forums, blogs, and stuff like that available. My personal recommendation though, if you're using an installer script, stick to WordPress. One notable feature that comes with S-Panel when managing your website is that you can create an unlimited amount of custom email accounts. For example, here I've created Emit at protechware.com, and I could make contacts at protechware.com or sales at protechware.com just as easily. And finally, you also get a free SSL certificate for absolutely every website on your server. This encrypts a website and turns this not secure message into a green padlock. Before we get into the performance results, I want to mention a very important aspect of my videos. If you're shopping for web hosting, you can actually get a discount for almost any web hosting provider by using the links down in the description below, so you could grab a better price. But these are affiliate links, meaning that if you buy anything, the web hosting provider will share part of the money that you spend with me, and this goes to support my channel and my content. At the moment, this is the only way I monetize my channel, and this allows me to stay independent, review a bunch of different providers, and give you the true, honest information. Thank you for allowing me to stay an independent content creator, and go grab those discounts. I've taken the liberty of doing some performance tests to see what type of performance can you expect from ScalaHosting. Keep in mind that I'm using their advanced plan, which is sufficient for way more than just one website, so I'll only be using around 20 to 30% available resources. With absolutely no optimizations made to my website, which looks like this by the way, it loads in around 1.5 seconds, with the server response time being around 0.6 seconds. However, by doing some free optimizations, by the way, I will leave a tutorial on how to do that on screen right now, I was able to get that loading time down to around 1.2 seconds. 1.2 seconds is actually way below the recommended 3-second mark by Google, and I'm not even stressing my server out at all. I'm using like 20 to 30% capacity. So I could have more visitors on there, I could have more websites, or I could just have a bigger website and the performance wouldn't degrade at all. So these plans start at around $10 a month, which is completely reasonable, because you are getting more than just a server. If you wanted just a virtual private server that's completely unmanaged, the price is around $5 with providers like A2 Hosting. But what does managed mean? Well, managed means you get all of the stuff I showed you earlier. Control panels, tools to set up your website, SSL certificates, email accounts, and you even get to register a name for your website. On top of that, you also get 24/7 live chat assistance if anything ever goes wrong. So technically, you're only paying around $5 for the web hosting itself, and the other $5 go to extra management tools and the help that you're getting. Which is a pretty sweet deal in my opinion, because you're getting the best of both worlds, good hardware and good software, especially considering that you can tweak the server settings to your liking to have that perfect web hosting server for you. Remember how I showed you earlier, this graph where it shows my website usage? What happens if, let's say, I run out of RAM?
Dedicated RAM, I should have the server.
Well, I don't need to pay 2 times or 3 times more to upgrade my web hosting plan. I can just add more RAM. By going into resources and choosing to add a couple more gigabytes of RAM on top of my existing plan, this only costs a couple dollars extra per month. Keep in mind that you can do this after you've purchased your plan. And not only you can add resources to make your plans more powerful, you can also remove them if you see that you're not using it to make your plans cheaper.
This is called modular billing, and this is just one of many advantages of using cloud or VPS services. Because your server is essentially just pooling resources from many different computers, you're in charge of how many resources you need. If you're just starting out, this is your first website or your first project, ScalaHosting or any VPS or cloud solution for that matter is a gross overkill. You'll probably achieve the wanted result with web hosting that can cost you from like $1 to $3 from Hostinger or Bluehost. But if you're a freelance designer working with multiple clients and websites, or you have a project that's quickly outgrowing shared hosting plans, most importantly, if you're looking to grow a business or an e-commerce store.
The extra $5 that you spend on Scala hosting will probably be some of the best spend, $5 each month, at least in terms of saving you time, because the managed aspect of Scala hosting will make sure to save you tens of hours each month, and your website will be more secure, faster, and you will get 24/7 live chat support if something does go wrong. Anyways, my name is Emit, this was my review of Scala hosting. You can get discounts for almost any web hosting provider in the description down below, and I wish you luck managing your servers.
Dedicated WAM to a server. WAM to a server. I was wondering, dedicated WAM, I should have to a server.